You start with a train of empty bulk cement wagons going to the plant at Clitheroe to be filled up to go back down south to kickstart our building industry. This is followed by another freight coming south to Crewe from Carlisle, all to keep our industry going. Thank you to all the staff and the railways for doing this job. And while we're into thank yous, I'd like to make a thank you to all the local businesses, the butchers for supplying meat and delivering it, the local fish market for delivering fish, and the kindness given by neighbours for doing the shopping for my wife and myself during lockdown. This awful time has brought a lot of local people together and brought the best out in people. And that's a real good thank you, as well as all the key workers who this video is dedicated to. Thank you. As we leave the real world, we come in to the model world. Freight train from Carlisle to Crewe was passed in the real world after an empty cement train went to Clitheroe to refill to go back down south. We now come to the world of models, starting with a thank you to the fishermen who keep us fed. Looks like somebody on the quay is having a brew. And the dockers, who also bring the goods so we can keep our country going. And the railways, there's a train full of milk tankers going to the dairy, so we can have milk for our cereals in the morning. And of course, the farmers who supply the milk from the cows and then to the supermarkets. We owe a big thank you to all the frontline workers, supermarket staff who keep us stocking groceries, and the market people, and of course the transport people who keep the buses and the coaches and the trains running so that we can have a normal life and one day return to normal gatherings and normal weddings and social events. Over and over to, and of course, we owe a big thank you to the men who take refuse away every week. What will we do without them? And one day we will have our cinemas back, hopefully, and the post office will do a good job getting the mail to and from and the parcels, and of course the postmen and women who do a wonderful job, and of course the emergency services, not forgetting the policemen, good old Bobby, and the ambulance people, and of course the NHS, the nurses and all the frontline staff to help us through this awful situation with COVID-19 coronavirus. As people don't seem to be distancing to 2 meters, do they? But we are allowed to go outdoors a bit now. Some of you are going to hike. I'm feeling all the books here. Banana bones, frozen food bones, Robertson's jams. We need all these things. And the brewery to keep the leisure industry going. And another post person there. And the passenger trains, of course. So it's a thank you to all the carers in the hospitals and the care homes who look after our people that badly need our help, the old people and the young people. Thank you so much. You all deserve a big, big clap. Thank you. And of course, our local hospice, the East Lakes Hospice, who's having a difficult time at the moment because all the shops are shut, and with the coronavirus having a big effect, they are feeling a pinch as much as anybody else. A local artist who I had the privilege to go to school with many years ago, does a calendar for the hospice every year of local scenes in East Lancashire, Blackburn. He's also a transport and railway enthusiast, as well as being a good local artist who does local scenes. We're hoping to put together a calendar for this year in the difficult circumstances. Here's one of our local stations, which closed in 1962, reopened at a new site in 1994, just a few hundred yards away. And a painting done by a 4-year-old child in support of the NHS. It was also a neighbour's child. And some more calendars done by John. Blackman scene, totally changed now, and a rural scene of Newton Village in the Ribble Valley. Thank you.